feel best in the tiny dresses. Some girls, nothing but sweatpants, looking like a princess. Some girls kiss new lips every single night. They're staying out late cause they just celebrating life. You know some days you feel so good in your own skin, but it's okay if you wanna change the body that you came in. Cause you look greatest when you feel like a damn queen. We're all just playing a game in a way, trying to win that life. Most girls are smart and strong and beautiful. Most girls work hard, go far, we are unstoppable. Most girls are fighting to make every day. No two are the same. To keep their physique real private. Some girls wear jeans so tight cause they feel so right, yeah. Some girls every day search and keep the beach turning, sleeping in late cause they just celebrating life. You know some days you feel so good in your own skin, but it's okay if you wanna change the body that you came in. To kickstart this prestigious event, we will begin with a blessing from Mrs. Tupaka.
Tua te kai me kiro marawa, nana I humai ngā mea katoa, nana I humai tēnei rangi tino a tāhua. I te tuatahi, pirangi au ki te mihi ki ngā manuhiri, ki Wainanui a tātou e. Mauria mai o koutou taonga, o koutou kōrero, o koutou whakaaro.
Which encourages young women into fields of low rates of female participation and mentoring, all about how we can empower young women to go forth and change the world, keeping up and we're actually benefiting from these changes. And that really brings me to my end vision. And my vision for Girl Boss New Zealand is that we really create a country where all of our young people can thrive and all of our young people are equipped with the skills they need to not only survive the technological revolution, but thrive in it. And New Zealand was the first country to give women the vote, and I believe that it can be the first country to give women full gender equity. Thank you.
She graduated from the University of Otago with a degree in medicine. As a junior doctor, she contracted Guillain-Barré syndrome, a rare disease that resulted in complete paralysis.
Dr. Maharaj spent 3 months in ICU, 5 months in a rehabilitation unit, followed by 2 years of physiotherapy. She had returned to Korea in medicine, where she specialized and is now a practicing pathologist at Auckland's North Shore Hospital. Dr. Maharaj is indeed an inspiration and a role model to all of us present here, as well as society at large, that no challenges will stand in her way of achieving her dreams.
I will now hand over the stage to Dr. Pauline Maharaj.
Hi, morning everyone. Thank you for having me. I'm very happy to be speaking to you today. Yes, I'm Pauline. I'm a doctor at North Shore Hospital, and I work as a surgical pathologist. I don't know how many of you know what a surgical pathologist is, because I know people are used to hearing about GPs and surgeons, but surgical pathology is a very important part of us, and I take what he says here very seriously, is that it always seems impossible until it's done. So I just wanted to tell you that things can get hard, and your life can take unexpected turns. But don't be discouraged and don't be limited by the situation in which you find yourself, because with hard work and a positive outlook, you can achieve anything that you want to. So, thanks for listening.
She has coached several New Zealand age group hockey teams and has been winner of the Prime Minister's Scholarship for Coaching. As well as this, she is a New Zealand touch guard and provincial representative for rugby, golf and squash.
Ms. Arthur is also a former PE teacher, director of sport and deputy principal. She is currently the head of Athlete Life at High Performance Sports New Zealand. Ms. Christine Arthur is highly competitive and passionate about sports, education, leadership, as well as helping others achieve their personal dreams.
Can we please welcome Ms. Christine Arthur over to the mic?
Success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It's the courage to continue that counts. So that's my first C for courage. Having the courage to chase your dreams. For me, sport has been a passion, and I chased my Olympic dream as a black stick, as the chef de mission for the Youth Olympics, and now I support future Olympians in my role as head of athlete life. The second C is for commitment, and commitment is what separates dreamers from achievers. Commitment's more about turning up to practice or attending a class, because commitment is an active, not a passive process, and you can choose to make a difference in the world. Every day you choose your attitude and which battles to fight. Choose wisely, as the little things you do can have a big impact on yourself and on others. I had a coach that gave me a really hard time, and it wasn't until my dad said, he must think you're going to be really good, and that's why he rides you so hard. As an athlete, people will judge you. Selectors may not pick you. The newspapers will surely rubbish you at times. And so you need to accept their opinions, both good and bad, but ultimately, you become your own critic. I played for New Zealand for 11 years, was dropped twice, had a knee reconstruction, and each time I had to pick myself up and regain a spot on the team. Sport teaches everyone the difference between being cocky, being cautious, and being confident to deliver your best.
To us, that we all are capable of accomplishing and exceeding in whatever we put our minds to. We are also reminded of how important it is for us females to empower each other throughout our own journeys.
A massive thank you to all our keynote speakers for your words of wisdom and taking us through a timeline of your great accomplishments.
As we bring this function to a close, we would like to acknowledge with gratitude AUT for sponsoring this event. Finally, a massive thank you to all of you for coming to Mission Heights First Women's Changemakers Breakfast. We wish you a pleasant day and drive safely. Thank you.